Morning, we're Reclaim Design. Today we're going to make a bath caddy or a bath tray. So we're going to turn this wood into one of these. It's great for the bath, you can put your toiletries on or whatever else. So the first order of the day is I've taken apart this pallet. I've checked for nails with my metal detector, there aren't any. So we're going to plane them down in the planer. And I've got my trusty book with all my measurements in. If I don't write everything down, I can never remember. So yeah, I've got this book full of really awesome drawings and stuff. Yeah, so first order of the day is planing. So let's get started. Cut these into the necessary strips for the bath caddy. So I'm going to do that on the table saw with the help of my handy jig. So this is my jointer sled. It's a little DIY number, and the idea is it's going to straighten up these edges. These are not too bad, but some of the boards are very bad. They either bow in or bow out, so when you're trying to join things together, that doesn't work. So what we do is we have a nice straight piece of plywood, and I put these toggle clamps on here. I've mounted them on. They're quite handy things. You can just push them down. I need to adjust these because this is quite thin wood now. But yeah, and a bit of sandpaper on there to stop it moving around. And we reference that off the fence of the table saw, and it gets nice straight edges for me then to turn it round and cut my other strips. Okay, so I've run those through the jointer sled, so we've got a nice straight edge to reference. I'm going to put it through the table saw to get my 4 centimeter thick strips. All the measurements for this project and with all the other projects are going to be on the tutorial on the blog, so I'm not going to explain all of that. If you want to find that out, you just go to the blog, which is linked below in the description, and the details are there as well. This is more just to walk you through the process visually. Strips. What we're going to do is cut them down into, we're going to cross cut them into smaller bits. So what I do is I've made a little DIY fence here, and this is why it's important to have a nice straight edge, because it references up against there quite well. Got my ruler, not very high tech, but it does work. Lower the saw, making sure you obviously don't turn the saw on, that wouldn't work out too well. And I set it on my ruler, so let's say 52 for the ones we're going to do now. And I use a little G-clamp, tighten it off, that's my stop block. So then I can repeat cut. And I just got to tidy up the end here. See, look, it's quite rough there, so I'm going to cut the end off there, which is what you'll see me do first, and I'll shift it up and make some cuts. Into the requisite sizes. next thing we're going to do is just sand them off before we fix them together, because it's going to make my life easier. So I've got this bench sander. It comes with some pretty cool little clamp things. I can attach it to the workbench so I can flip it upside down. I mean, you could make your own. I had a previous one that I made a housing for. You can do it yourself that way too. But it is quite handy, it comes with those. It's much easier to operate it that way than to try and hold these and use a sander that weighs 5 kilos. It's, not gonna work. So this way works well. Sanded those battens down, and now what I'm going to do is space them out and fix them to the handles. So what I've got is just some scrap pieces of wood that are all planed to the same thickness, and I'll shove them in between. That's just roughly laid out, and then I'm going to nail them in and glue them in from that side, which is where this bad boy comes in extremely handy. Sanded that down a little bit, so what I'm going to do is run an edge around the side, decorative edge, just to make it look nice, with a chamfer bit on my router table, which is this. So I'll run this, it's a 45 degree bit, and I'll just set the depth, run it around there, do some more final sanding, and then cover it with shellac to protect it from water. Thank you. basically taking the edges off with a piece of old sanding disc, just to get, it's quite hard to get in with a machine, so you have to sort of do it by hand, so that's what I'm doing now. Then I'll run over it with an orbital sander, and when that's nice and smooth and finished, I'll coat it with shellac, and shellac's insect excretion, which is gives a nice covering, and it works quite quickly. Instead of having to wait for 4 hours for it to dry, it takes a lot less time, so there's a benefit to using that as well. This is my shellac that I've made up, and I'm going to use these. These are, I don't know what they're called actually, but you basically use it to lift your piece off of the work surface, so you can actually use shellac or paint or whatever all the way around without getting it stuck onto the surface. So, and some mess for cleaning the brush and for thinning out the shellac if I need it. And this is what the shellac looks like. I haven't used it in a few months, so we'll see. There we go. I'm just finishing it off now, going coat of shellac, sanding out any roughness, and that's it done.